chimuira ko pambana ikumusa utsae kumabwenzi latu Yesu atikonda konda fe tipunzitse mbuye Yesu tikondane nanutu tisaiwalire kose wenzilatu
Chakechi,
chikondano,
chikondano,
mabwenzi la tu Yesu ati konda konda fe tipunzitse buye Yesu ti kondane na nutu tisaiwalire kose bwenzi latu dinutu chikondano
chikondano chake
chikondano
chikondano chake
chachiku Chikulu,
chikulu, chikulu, chikulu, chikulu.
kwenzi la tu Yesu atikonda konda fe tipunzitse buye Yesu tikondane na nutu tisaiwalire kose wenzi latu dinutu chikondano
chikondano chake
chikondano
chikondano chake
Bambana di kumusa tae koma bwenzi latu Yesu ati konda konda fe tipunzitse buye Yesu tikondane na I walire kose wenzi latu dinutu chikondano
chikondano chake
chikondano
chikondano chake
chachikulu Timchimuira, kupambana, diku bwenzi la tu Yesu atikonda konda fe tipunzitse buye Yesu tikondane na nutu tisaiwalire kose bwenzi la tu
Chicken,
mabwenzi la tu Yesu atikonda konda fe tipunzitse buye Yesu tikondane nanu tu tisaiwalire Ose wenzila tu dinu tu
Chicken,
ti konda konda fe ti punzitse buye Yesu ti kondane na nutu ti saiwalire kose wenzila tu
Wednesday.
la tu Yesu ati konda konda fe ti punzitse buye Yesu ti kondane na nutu ti saiwalire kose wenzila tu Thank you. mabwenzi la tu Yesu ati konda konda fe tipunzitse buye Yesu tikondane na nutu tisaiwali re
Pambana, Tikumusa,
bwenzi la tu Yesu atikonda konda fe tipunzitse buye Yesu tikondane na nutu tisaiwalire kose wenzila tu dinutu chikondano
chikondano chake
chikondano
chikondano chake
chachikulu Thank you.
From the moment that I wake till I lay my head. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh, yes, you have.
And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything, oh Lord. Your
The bride is walking in. Let's stand as the bride walks in.
Let the ancient words impart.
much. Sincere apologies. Some of you came right on time for beginning the marriage ceremony late. I don't like to condemn before I find out the reason. The reason might have been genuine, but nevertheless, sincere apologies. We will sing the first hymn while standing, and this is hymn number 18, Grace Hymnal, number 18. Come we that love the Lord, and let our joys be known. We do not have a pianist, so we'll just start. Once it is beamed, is it beamed already? Can't see. Is it beamed? Come we that love the Lord, and let our joys be known. Join in a song with sweet accord. Join in a song with sweet accord. And thus around the throne, and thus around the throne, we are marching to Zion. Beautiful Zion, marching past to Zion, the beautiful city of God. The sorrows of the man is from the place. Religion never was designed, never was designed to make a pleasures list, to make a pleasures list. We are marching to Zion. Beautiful Zion, upwards to Zion, the beautiful city of God. Let those refuse to see you are God, but children of the heavenly King. Joys abroad, may speak the joys abroad. We are marching to Zion. Wonderful Zion, marching past to Zion, the beautiful city of God. Lady of Zion, yield a thousand sacred sweet before we reach the heavenly field. Before we reach the heavenly fields, or walk the garden streets, or walk the garden streets, we are marching to Zion. Beautiful Zion, my
marching upwards to Zion, the beautiful city of God. There shall we see his face, never see. There from the rivers of his grace, there from the rivers of his grace, drinking this pleasure, sing, drinking this pleasure, sing. We are marching to Zion, beautiful, beautiful Zion, marching across to Zion, the beautiful city of God. Then let us songs about every day be dry. We're marching through Emmanuel's grave. We're marching through Emmanuel's grave to Phiri. We are marching Zion, beautiful, beautiful Zion. We are marching upwards to Zion, the beautiful city of God.
Thank you very much. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the face of this company to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is commended of the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these two persons present come now to be joined together. Let's come before the Lord in prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, the Father of the Lord Jesus, we thank thee for thy dear Son, our Lord, who came into this world to bear our sins in his body, that might have a people to himself, the church, which is the bride of thy Son. O Lord, we are waiting for that day of glorification, consummation. O Lord, when we shall be with our dear Savior. This ceremony reminds us of what awaits the people of God, the marriage supper of the Lamb, where the church will be adorned without any blemish. Oh Lord, what we are witnessing here is a picture of what shall take place. We thank thee, Lord, for Evaristo and Jessy. It has been a long journey. Now, as they come to unite in holy matrimony, we ask thy blessings upon this ceremony. Guide us through every segment. Oh Lord, we beseech thee that we might truly know thy blessings in everything that we shall do. Abide with us, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. The congregation may now be seated. Okay. Doubly blessed is the couple which comes to the marriage altar with the approval and blessings of their families and friends. Who has the honor of presenting this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Ryder. Okay. I ask you, Evaristo, to unveil the bride. Doing it carefully. He's doing it carefully. I did it suddenly. Thank you. I require and charge you both in the sight of God that if either of you know any just cause why you may not be joined together in marriage, that you may do now confess it. Evaristo and Jessy, the covenant which you are about to make with each other is meant to be a beautiful and sacred expression of your love for each other. As you pledge your vows to each other, and as you commit your lives to each other, we ask that you do so in all seriousness, and yet with a deep sense of joy, with a deep conviction that you are committing yourselves to a dynamic, growing relationship of trust, mutual support, and caring love. Evaristo, Susu, will you have Jessy Phiri to be your wedded wife, to live together according to God's holy ordinance of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, cling only to her as long as both of you shall live?
I will.
Similarly, Jessy Phiri, will you have Evaristo Susu to be your wedded husband, to live together according to God's holy ordinance of marriage? Will you obey him and serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, cling only to him as long as both of you shall live?
Yes, I will.
Thank you. You are now going to exchange the vows and face each other and hold the hands. Face each other like that and hold hands. I'll start with the groom. Evaristo, will you please repeat after me your wedding vows to Jessy? I, Evaristo Susu.
I, Evaristo Susu.
Take you, Jessy Phiri.
Take you, Jessy Phiri.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Until death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And to that end.
And to that end.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
To the bride. Jessy, will you please repeat after me your wedding vows to Evaristo?
I call upon all these people here
to witness that I,
to witness that I,
Jessy Phiri,
Jessy Phiri, take you, Evaristo Susu,
to be my lawful wedded husband,
to be my lawful wedded husband,
to have and to hold,
to have and to hold,
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
for better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love,
to love,
cherish,
cherish,
and to obey,
and to obey,
till death do us part,
till death do us part,
according to God's holy ordinance,
according to God's holy ordinance,
and to that end,
and to that end,
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
At this time, the couple will exchange the rings. The couple will exchange the rings.
Lord of light, oh come to this wedding, take the doubt and darkness away, turn the water of lifeless living to the wine of gladness, we pray. Mother Mary, gently requesting that you might do whatever you can, though she may be impatient, she loves you, and so she asks what she can't understand. Lord of light, oh come to this wedding, take the doubt and darkness away, turn the water of lifeless living to the wine of gladness, we pray. So amidst the laughter and feasting, there sits Jesus, full with the fun. He has made them one.
Okay. They can sit, can't they? Just find the seat for the children. The wedding ring is a symbol of eternity. It's an outward sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in love. And now, as a token of your love and of your deep desire to be united in heart and soul, you, Evaristo, may place a ring on the finger, by thee wed.
By thee wed.
Bride, Evaristo, I give you this ring as a symbol of our vows,
as a symbol of our vows,
and as a token of all,
and as a token of all
that we shall share in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit,
and of the Holy Spirit.
With this ring I thee word. I'm addressing these words to the congregation. For as much as Evaristo Susu and Jessy Phiri have covenanted together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and these witnesses, and thereto have pledged their faithfulness to each other, and have pledged the same by the giving and receiving each of a ring, by the authority vested in me according to the law in the Republic of Zambia, and as the minister of the gospel in the Church of Christ, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What therefore God has joined together, let not man put asunder. Evaristo and Jessy, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you his peace. Amen. We'll ask the couple to kneel, and we'll ask the couple to kneel. We'll call Elder Milandu. Reverend Nyerenda is also here. Would you come? Brother.
gracious Father in heaven.
Our gracious Father in heaven, we thank you for this day, this very special day in the lives of Evaristo and Jessy, when they have been joined together in holy matrimony. Our Father, we are so grateful that indeed your ways are past finding out. We cannot trace what you are doing because you are God and you are sovereign over all things. And we stand to testify of your goodness and mercy in the lives of the two. Indeed, you work in mysterious ways, your wonders to perform. Indeed, your wonders in the lives of these two, in bringing them to yourself, and now, Lord, in joining them in holy matrimony. We do ask, dear Lord, that you will bless this couple, that you will cause their ways to be established in you, that even as they journey together forward from this time, that you will, O God, lead them and cause them to cherish each other and to love you above all things. We ask that their marriage will grow, even as they grow in their walk with you, that you bless them richly, and that the body of Christ will indeed be blessed through the two, even as they serve you and witness the wonders of Christ in their lives. We ask, Father, for your blessing upon this couple, and even as we join them in celebrating, in giving thanks, Father, we pray that this day will be blessed of you, undertake for them, and may the Lord Jesus Christ be honored. We thank you, Father, and we commend them into your hands at this time and all their lives together. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Chairs. Yes. Before we turn to God's word, we can sing hymn number 200 in Chewa, Wina Atikonda. 200 in Nyimbo. I hope it will be displayed. Is it displayed? Wina Atikonda ife. To Tifuna Fenzire Ute to Chi Konda no Chi Konda no Chikundanu cha chikunu Di cha chikunu Yes.
to kedwa pichi konda no chi konda no. Kuru de chachi kuru kuru de pansi pano zira o chi. Chachi kuru kuru de chachi kuru kuru de mui ra na usa usa e. Chikundanu chachi kuru kuru di chachi kuru kuru di buye wesu to inu to chikondanu 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 cha chikuru kuru chachi kuru kuru di.
We now turn to God's word as we find it in 1 Peter chapter 3. 1 Peter and chapter 3. We will read the first 7 verses of 1 Peter chapter 3. Wives, likewise, be submissive to your own husbands, that even if some do not obey the word, they without a word may be won by the conduct of their wives, when they observe your chaste conduct accompanied by fear. Do not let your adornment be merely outward, arranging the hair, wearing gold, or putting on fine apparel, Rather, let it be the hidden person of the heart with the incorruptible beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is very precious in the sight of God. For in this manner, in former times, the holy women who trusted in God also adorned themselves, being submissive to their own husbands, as Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord, whose daughters you are, if you do good and are not afraid with any terror. Husbands, likewise, dwell with them with understanding, giving honor to the wife as to the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers may not be hindered. The duties of married persons. Your duties, Evaristo and Jessy. And indeed, it's good, all of us who are here, if we are married, or we hope to marry, or we hope to be married, to be reminded of our duties in marriage. In the letters of Paul and Peter, they spend a lot of time writing instructions for wives and husbands. You read Ephesians, for instance, and Colossians, and here in 1 Peter, these two apostles spend a lot of time to write about marriage. Marriage is very important. It's what builds society. When we see society breaking down, it points to the individual family unit. If we have strong families, we will have good or strong society. Now, in this passage we have just read, Peter talks about duties of wives and husbands. He says a bit more about the wife rather than compared to the husband. The duties of a husband are all in verse 7, and yet he spends 6 verses talking about the duties of a wife. I was just wondering why he does that. And I think it's because of peculiar circumstances in which sometimes women find themselves. Perhaps at the time Peter was writing this book, there were Christian women who were married to non-believing husbands. At first, they were both unbelievers. The gospel came, they believed, while their husbands remained non-believers. So they were in very peculiar circumstances. So he spends a bit more time to talk about the duties of wives. I'll just quickly go through the duties. We will begin with the duties of wives. As I've said, I'm addressing them, but all of us who are here, a good number of us may be in marriage already. The duties of wives. What are the duties of wives? There are 3 he talks about in this passage. The first one is submission. Verse 1, wives likewise be submissive to your own husband. Wives are to submit. to their own husbands. Now, that statement in itself implies that in a marriage, there is leadership which God has put there. And this leadership role or duty has been entrusted to the man. He is to lead the family. He is to guide the family. And as he does so, wives are to submit. Now, I can spend a lot of time talking about submission here. We are not talking about submitting to him in the wrong things that are contrary to the word of God, but in the things that are right. You women or wives are to submit to their own husbands. The word submit has been misunderstood by the world. There are a lot of groups that have come up with movements that talk against submission. When the Bible talks about submission, it's not talking about slavery. The Bible does not mean that the man is therefore superior. We are just talking about roles. As far as our standing before God is concerned, husbands and wives, if they are Christians, they are one in the Lord. So we are just talking about roles. God has given specific roles to husbands and specific roles to wives. It's not about inferiority complex here. It's not slavery. Doesn't mean wives are inferior to their husbands. It is simply the roles that wives have to perform. Notice here that the Bible is saying, wives, be submissive. You are to make yourself submissive to him. Meaning, it's a positive concept we are talking about here. What is submission? If I may define submission, what is submission? Submission means that the wife yields and uses all of her abilities under the management of her husband. It means yielding to him. It means if you have abilities, you yield them to support him, to help him. That's what submission is all about. The wife yields and uses all her abilities under the management of her husband for the good of her husband and family. Now, we are given a reason why, as I said, we can spend a lot of time on submission. The reason is given why you are to submit, wives are to submit, that even if some do not obey the word, they without a word may be won by the conduct of their husbands. These two are Christians. But if there is a wife here who is married to a man who is not a Christian, by your submitting to him, such a person might be won to the Lord. Such a person might embrace the gospel. But the lesson is this for all of us, that character is powerful. Character can draw others to the Savior. If we have good character, we may win others to the Savior. Evaristo is a Christian. If you submit in a Christian way, he might even become a better Christian. That's what the Bible is teaching us here. It's an encouragement that if you submit, if you are married to a non-believer, such a one might be drawn to the Savior. And they would do that as they observe your conduct, that they without a word may be won by the conduct of their wives. When they observe your chaste conduct, when these husbands who are not believing, or even who are believing, they observe your purity of life, your consecration to the Lord, your godliness, your holiness, they will be drawn to the Savior. Again, we are seeing here the power of character. There's a second duty for wives, and this one is negative, what they should not concentrate on. Their beauty should not be merely outward, what you should not concentrate on. That is the second duty. Verse 3, do not let your adornment be merely outward. The Bible is not saying you don't pay attention to your dresses, to the way you look, but it's saying that must not become the main focus in your life. In your life. That's what it's saying. Your concentration must not be, how is my hair looking like? How is my dress? Spending too much time on these things. Concentrating on outward beauty. There's such a thing as inward beauty, and we shall be looking at that in a minute. Do not let your adornment or beauty be merely outward. And he gives examples there. The hair, the wearing of gold. I have seen ladies with gold on the tongue. I wonder how they got it on the tongue. When they laugh, you just see gold on the tongue. And the wearing of expensive clothes, putting on fine apparel. The Bible is not against looking good, if you can. But the danger here is that you can be taken up with these things, how you are looking, your appearances, to the point whereby you neglect your soul, what he calls the inner beauty. And that takes me to the third point, the third duty. The third duty, which is their souls must be adorned with grace. You must concentrate on inward beauty. Proverbs says, beauty is fleeting. It passes away with time. From here you go for wedding photos. If the Lord blesses you with children, they come and look at your photos 50 years from now, and if you will be alive, they won't believe it. You will have aged. Your hair will be gray. That beauty will be reduced. But there is another kind of beauty which remains. And this is the inner beauty, the character. This beauty remains. It lasts. Even if you age, and that's what Proverbs says, beauty is fleeting. Charm is fleeting. But a woman who fears the Lord shall be praised or shall be desired. So the encouragement here, the other duty here is concentrate on your soul, on your character, that inner beauty, not merely outward. Now, these are things which we can easily ignore as the people of God. Verse 4, rather let it be the hidden person of the heart. Inner beauty, your soul, with the incorruptible beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit. Cultivate meekness. Cultivate humility. This is a duty for women. And the Bible is saying here that God delights in this grace of humility. Spend much time working at your soul much time reading God's word, much time cultivating the graces in your lives. And we are given examples there. For in this manner, in former times, the holy women who trusted God also adorned themselves. We are given examples in the Old Testament and perhaps even in the New that there were women who adorned themselves with inner beauty. Sarah was a beautiful woman, we are taught in the Bible. And yet, there was something much more than just outward beauty. She adorned herself with this inner beauty. We are given examples of holy women in the Bible who trusted God, who were submissive to their husbands. We are told of Sarah, who called Abraham Lord. And you are daughters of Sarah if you imitate Sarah. So those are the three duties for women, Christian women. Let us come to the duties of the man or husbands, which are mentioned in verse 7. Husbands likewise dwell with them with understanding. The first duty for husbands is be considerate. I think that's the way it is put in the NIV. Be considerate. Other versions say, live with them according to understanding. Dwell with them with understanding. What does it mean to live with them according to understanding? It means that let the word of God be the guide in the way you will treat your wife. The Bible has much to say about the way you should relate to her. Be like the Lord Jesus Christ. Imitate Christ, who loved his church sacrificially. Do the same. Be considerate to her. Live in accordance with Christian knowledge, which we find in the Word of God. Be considerate. You are to be guided by the Word of God. What that means, dear friends, is that you are to protect her. You are to protect her. You are to provide for her. You are to labor for her. That's what it comes to when the Bible says, live with them according to knowledge, or be considerate. That is the first duty for husbands, the first duty to you, Evaristo. In case you are wondering how you are going to do this, just read the Word of God, just read the Scriptures, and they will be your guide, even as you relate to her. The other duty for the man is to honor her. Look at verse 7b. Dwell with them according to knowledge, giving honor to the wife. You are to honor her. And the reason is given. Now, look at this. In verse 1, it says, wives, be submissive. And then later on, the husband is addressed. Honor her. It's not a contradiction. You are to show honor to her, respect to her. It's bad manners if she makes a mistake and you embarrass her in the public. Those things can wait until you are home somewhere. No, honey, maybe I wasn't happy with that comment you made. Rather than beginning to shout at her in the public, you are to respect her. I'm just giving you an example of what honor should be like. And the reason is given why you are to respect her. She's a weaker vessel. That's what the Bible says. She is a weaker vessel, giving honor to the wife as the weaker vessel. Now, that statement can be misunderstood. She's not a weaker vessel in terms of the intellect, and I think she's a weaker vessel in terms of her makeup. You are stronger than her physically. So you are to honor her because she is a weaker vessel. You have to take up much on you. As the stronger of the two, you ought to shoulder the heavier responsibilities. You know, sometimes what women do, if you have two cars and she has a puncture, she will just call the husband. Ah, I have a puncture. Come. And immediately the husband comes, she gets into the other car and drives home. He's left behind. And you have to now battle it out. And that's the way it should be. You know? She is a weaker vessel. This means protect her physically. Protect her. If thieves come, they are knocking on the door at night, it should not be you telling Jessy, Jessy, can you go and check, just find out who is knocking on the door. It should be you. Whether you receive a bullet or not, it should be you. Protect her. And there are times when, let me talk about this, protect her from family members. There are times when family members, maybe from both sides, begin to complain. No, you know, she doesn't cook big in Shima for us. And you must protect her from your relatives, from anyone who is bringing false accusations against her. Protect her. And what is the other thing as a weaker vessel? Provide for her needs. Provide for her needs. If she's a weaker vessel, the responsibility to provide for her is largely on you. She may compliment, but it is the responsibility of the man to labor and provide for the family. You are to show honor. And we are told the reason why you are to honor her or respect her. She's a weaker vessel. But the other reason is that you are heirs together. Look at what he says in verse 7. As being heirs together of the grace of life. Both of you have believed in the Lord Jesus Christ. Both of you are believers in the Lord. Both of you are partakers of the grace of God. In as far as your standing before God is concerned, you are the same. And if you are the same, you belong to the same Savior, you should respect her. You should respect her. That is the other reason we are given. The third reason, which is given for the man to honor the wife, is that your prayers may not be hindered. By implication here, we are being told that couples ought to pray. There are many couples here, perhaps, and elsewhere, who may not be spending time in prayer. Pray together. And I'm emphasizing that. In marriage, there will be challenges you come across. You may have a difficult son, a difficult daughter, sicknesses, bereavement, all these things may come. We don't live in a perfect environment. How do you get the help from the Lord? Spend time together every day. You may decide that we'll be praying in the morning, because by the time you come back, you are so tired, you just want to eat and sleep. But whatever time you set, spend time in prayer. You may just begin by spending 5 minutes every day. And couples who are here, if you don't pray, please stop that bad habit. Begin to pray with your spouses, beginning this day. She reminds me sometimes when I'm too busy, honey, we haven't prayed. We haven't sought the face of the Lord. Sometimes I may be very sleepy. We haven't prayed. I have to wake myself up, and we spend time in prayer, praying for various situations. The Lord answers prayer. I don't want to go into details of how he has answered our prayers. As a family, we have faced very trying situations, but we have brought each one of them before the Lord. He's been very faithful. He answers prayer. Jessy and Evaristo, spend time in prayer. One of the things I love about this couple, they are ever on time at church. They are never late. 10 hours sharp, they are at church. Please maintain those good habits. Spend time together in prayer. God answers prayer. In conclusion, we have been here for quite a while. What are we saying? I will just quickly again go through the roles for wives. Submission. It is as you submit that you will find your fulfillment in marriage. As you submit to him, you are actually obeying the Lord. And as he honors you, you find the marriage estate fulfilling. Submission. Number two, your beauty should not be merely outward. Number three, your souls must be adorned. Put on character, meekness, gentleness. Cultivate these graces in your life. The Lord will help you. The Lord will be with you. The Lord knows that you are a weaker vessel. Look to the Lord. Depend upon the Lord. You are obeying the Lord. As for you, Evaristo, be considerate. Live with her according to understanding, according to the word of God. Let the word of God. You walked in here with a song, Holy Word, Well Preserved, for our walk in this world, isn't it? Let the word of the Lord, the ancient word of God, guide you in this marriage, and respecting her, sometimes, I know as you grow in grace, there are certain mistakes I wouldn't advise you to make. Careless words, you are hurt, you just utter careless words that may injure someone. I may have uttered bad words, or unkind words some time ago, and I regret of them. As you grow in grace, and I wouldn't want you to make those mistakes. Respecting her, she is a weaker vessel, requiring your attention, requiring your protection. Respect her, honor her as a weaker vessel. And as you do that, the Lord will be with you. As you do that, your prayers will not be hindered. The Lord will answer your prayers. Amen. So we will now We'll sing our last hymn. After singing our last hymn, we'll ask the couple to go in there for signing of the register. We will stand and sing number 725. But before we do that, let's just come to the Lord in prayer once again. Our Father, we thank thee for the instructions we get from your word. Clear duties, clear roles, we pray that, oh Lord, we may carry them out. The specific roles for wives, the specific roles for husbands. We pray, Lord, that you might give us grace to honor thee in our marriages, and particularly for Evaristo and Jessy. We ask in Jesus' name, amen. Let's stand and sing 725. 725. At the end of this hymn, we'll ask the couple to go and sign the register together with the witnesses. 725.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me down to lie in pastures green. He leadeth me the quiet waters by. My soul, it doth restore again, and me to walk doth make within the paths of righteousness in for his own namesake. Yet though I walk in this dark valley, yet will I fear no evil, for thou art with me, and thy rod and staff may comfort thee. My table thou hast furnished, the presence of my foes, my ear does with oil and oil. Man, my cup overflows. Goodness and mercy, oh, my life shall surely follow me, and in God's house forevermore my dwelling place shall be.
And you can now go for the signing register. And the witnesses, parents. Witnesses and parents can go to the vestry the Susu.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing Your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Your holy name. You're rich in love and You're slow to anger. Your name is great and Your heart is kind. For all Your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. I worship Your holy name. Come on, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Your holy name. Yes, I will worship Your holy name. Lord, I worship Your holy name. Sing like never. Worship Your holy name.
worship your holy name. Worship your holy name.
You unravel me with a melody, you surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears have come.
Mr. and Mrs. Susu.
We celebrate
all you've done, Lord.
tried me when no one could.
Come on, say you are the love.
You are the love that never leaves. I am here to testify, Lord.
Come on.
Of how you took away my shame.
Now listen.
You make something out of nothing.
Hey,
I can't deny your love for me.
I can't deny your love, Lord, for me.
I'm in a lost for words.
I'm in a lost, I'm in a lost for words.
Life is not the same again.
We testify,
yeah.
We celebrate, we celebrate. For all you've done, Lord,
let me give you all the praise.
This is my day of victory.
For everything you've done for me, I gotta stand and testify.
Unedi Eshimisha Yesu. This is my day to celebrate.
For everything you've done for me, I gotta stand and testify.
I gotta dance and testify. Come on, come on, come on.
Dinali, chikonda no,
Yeah.